paper chromatography, basic pieces of equipment are a piece of paper, in this case a table napkin, a solvent such as plain tap water, and a substance, for example, blue-black ink, which will be analyzed. After the napkin has been spotted and the ink has been allowed to dry, it is carefully draped so as to draw up the solvent by capillary action. Soon the solvent moves through the substance. Within 30 minutes, the resulting chromatographic separation shows that the ink is made up of four different substances. This is called a chromatogram. To refine the technique, a good grade of filter paper is substituted. This is hung by a paper clip hook inserted in a cork. Note the capillary movement and chromatographic separation in this time-lapse sequence where 15 minutes has been shortened to about 15 seconds. The distinct differences in these chromatograms are due to the fact that different papers have a different degree of physical attraction for the particular molecules in the substance. A biological substance is now used, chlorophyll extract from the leaves of a Virginia creeper vine. Each spot must be allowed to dry thoroughly before the paper is placed in the solvent. Changing to more effective solvents, petroleum ether is in one beaker and acetone in the other. Solvents often move up the paper at different rates. Because of different solubilities in different solvents, the substances in the mixtures separate differently. The petroleum ether is better for separating some, acetone is better for separating others. Combining the two solvents, therefore, should give even better results. The action has been speeded up three times here by the camera. Compare the chlorophyll extract separated by a mixture of the two solvents with the single solvent chromatograms. The solvent mixture gives the best separation. Now, a 8% acetone in petroleum ether is carefully poured into a large glass tube. This gives another improvement, a saturated atmosphere. On the filter paper strip, a pencil line is marked 1 inch from the end, and on this is spotted the chlorophyll extract. The strip has been cut to fit inside the tube without touching either side. Before the solvent front reaches the top, the chromatogram is removed, and the front is marked with a pencil line. On the finished chromatogram are carotene, xanthophyll, chlorophyll A, and chlorophyll B. Here is a closer look at the chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. The rate of migration can be calculated for each substance and recorded as an RF value. RF is the ratio of the fronts and is equal to the distance the substance front moved divided by the distance the solvent front moved in a given time. For example, if the substance front moved 5 centimeters and the solvent front 10 centimeters, the RF value would be 0.50. In other words, the substance would have moved 50% of the distance that the solvent moved. On this chromatogram, the solvent moved 12.5 centimeters. Measuring from the first pencil line to the solvent front. Carotene moved 12 centimeters and therefore has an RF value of 0.96. Xanthophyll moved 8 centimeters and has an RF value of 0.64. Chlorophyll A moved 3.5 centimeters and has an RF value of 0.28. Chlorophyll B moved 2.5 centimeters and has an RF value of 0.20. The method shown here is called ascending chromatography because the solvent moves up the paper strip. Another method of ascending chromatography uses a largemouth gallon jar. The solvent is a 4:1:1 mixture of butanol, glacial acetic acid, and distilled water. It is poured to a depth of about 1/2 inch. Replacing the cover produces a saturated atmosphere. A flat sheet of filter paper is carefully marked and labeled. Micropipettes are used to spot small amounts of 3 separate amino acids, alanine, serine, and leucine. On the fourth mark, a mixture of all 3 is spotted. This is repeated 2 or 3 times in order to increase the concentration of the substances, allowing each spot to dry between applications. The rolled and stapled sheet, handled only by the edges, is carefully placed in the chamber. It is removed about 4 hours later, before the solvent front has reached the top of the sheet. The amino acids are colorless and must therefore be sprayed with an indicator such as a 0.25% solution of ninhydrin in acetone in order to bring out the color. As this dries, the amino acids gradually appear as purple spots in this sequence that has been speeded up 3 times. Alanine, serine, and leucine have different rates of migration. All three can be seen, therefore, in the separation of the mixture. On the far right is the chromatographic separation of a spot of soybean sauce made from the highly proteinaceous soybean. The two amino acids circled are probably alanine and leucine because of their position on the chromatogram. Another method of paper chromatography uses a circular disc of filter paper. In the descending method, the solvent moves down the filter paper. Using different methods and solvents, the possibilities are endless for separating mixtures of substances using paper chromatography.